My name's John Easley with Carbon 6 Rings. My wife and I started a small ring business about a year ago. I had a dream to be able to manufacture and to own my own shop. As I've been working to try to build that up, I've had a difficult time finding machines that were appropriately sized in the price range with the capacity to do the kinds of products that I needed to. And I recently found Detroit machines, and I've been using them to be able to competitively make rings and sell them. When I did the Kickstarter, I sold a ring that was difficult to make on a machine. At the time, I thought I would sell a few rings and I would be able to do them by hand, but because it was a popular ring and cut more orders than we originally estimated, it became unreasonable for me to do them just by hand. And so we needed to find a way to be able to consistently keep the quality and make them in a fashion that would help us to do it in a timely manner. And we went through 3 or 4 different machine shops to try to get these machines, these rings made. And finally, with the SL6, because of the capacity it has, I was able to, within a few weeks of training and help from Kade, write the program and set up the tooling to be able to cut these rings out, which we've been struggling to make for 8 or 9 months. And so now I can consistently make the rings that we promised and fulfill the commitment we originally made to our customers, and also, you know, start to sell these rings in the market. And so I'm grateful to Detroit Machines to make it possible for me to keep my commitments to my customers and also to be competitive. Okay, this is the model machine that I own. It's an SL6. And one of the great things about this machine is that it makes micromanufacturers have the capacity to do things that they couldn't before do. Most lathes only have one axis and then a tool block. With this lathe, we have the capacity to have a typical Z axis and X, and also a C axis, along with an additional gang tool that allows for live tooling. The way that we use this is I put my tools to cut the rings inside of the turret, and along with a bar puller, and we put the stock inside of the chuck. And on this block, I have a live tool spindle. And so for the designs that we make that require more than just the typical two axis that a lathe does, we're able to do them because of all the capacity that these lathes offer. We're able to make a whole ring in one operation with complicated contours on it that wouldn't be possible if I was using a traditional lathe with the two axes, or one that is in a price range and a machine size that I could fit in my shop and actually afford to use. What's great about the Detroit machines is it makes it possible for someone that's a small shop like me to be able to reasonably get into the manufacturing and boutique ring business or any kind of making business. So I'm able to afford a machine that has the capacity and is at the appropriate size and price range for me to be able to make rings profitably. And as we grow, I'm able to buy machines that are appropriately sized for me, that have the right features on them that I can pick to line up, so I'm able to have a machine that works with the power capacity of my shop, the size capacity of my shop, within a price range that can make me competitive against much larger companies. And I feel like this is a quality of Detroit machines that's going to make them sort of lead the way in this micromanufacturing business, that as China and other machine shops, their prices are going up, it's becoming realistic for smaller people, smaller manufacturers like me, to be able to compete on a global level, because we have access to programs that can help us program the shapes and contours needed in the machine, and marketing and distribution through the internet that allows us to sell to the whole world.